In need of healing, Arisen.
Give them water!
By your leave. I grant you roaring flame. Stay with me, Arisen. Don't fight back.
There are useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
Shall we see if there's aught to be found while we're here? Hold fast, Arisen! I will be with you in but a moment!
To have come through unscathed.
Overconfidence is an enemy in and of itself. Let us instead strive to better ourselves with every battle.
During my travels beyond the rift, I learned of a cave near here that you have yet to explore. Shall I take us there?
But methinks 'twill budge if we combine our strength.
Shall we set it rolling? A treasure chest. Shall we see if we can't make our way over to it?
Solitary shard is good for little. We need to seek out more of these, if 'tis to be of use.
We must take care not to throw it away by mistake.
Pray, slow your feet. You run too fast for the likes of me.
Let us endeavor to keep up, though we are less fleet of foot. Ah, I'll take that. We might find a use for it.
I would gladly be a bait, Arisen. Allow me. Goblins, master!
We have no means of exploiting our enemy's weakness.
Guard all you want. It won't make a difference when I've grappled, you see?
Let my magic imbue your weapon with the fury of the elements.
I see you travel without your loyal pawn. You will need to rectify that, should you seek my service.
I see you travel without your loyal pawn. You will need to rectify.
Halt! You are approaching the gates of Vernworth, capital of Vermund. None may pass without the proper documents. If you've an entry permit, an invitation, or proof of citizenship, present it now. I see. So you are to meet with Captain Brandt. I shan't impede you then. Come with me.
I was informed of your coming would be arisen.
Captain Brandt, you should know that this individual fought valiantly to defend the troops. The Watchhead told me himself.
As decreed by the great will of our world, there can only be one arisen. That arisen now resides within the palace. Indeed, he is our sovereign and the rightful ruler of Vermund. It follows, therefore, that this ruffian before us is naught but a pretender. You must submit to questioning. If you value your life, you will not attempt to flee. I shall conduct the interrogation myself. Stand watch outside. I beg your forgiveness for my insolence, Your Majesty. If the Queen Regent had learned of your existence, I fear your life would have been in peril. I had no choice but to treat you as a pretender, lest my actions draw suspicion from watchful eyes. Then you have truly lost your memory? In that case, mayhap I ought to explain the situation before we proceed. You, and no other, are the sovereign. The only legitimate ruler of this kingdom. Some days passed, you confronted the dragon in the village of Melv, whereupon you became arisen. The people rejoiced, for our true liege had finally appeared, and in Vermund's long years of council rule. Yet, not all celebrated your coming. Your arrival would have robbed the Queen Regent Deesa of everything. During the time of the previous council, she acted as a queen in her own right, ruling the palace as she saw fit. And just after the council's passing, when 'twas all but certain that her son would take his father's place, word reached the castle that the Arisen had been found. To Deesa, Your Majesty's very existence is naught but an obstacle to her own family's continued prosperity. The assassination of the Arisen is an impossible feat for mortal hands. Thus, Deesa chose to abduct Your Majesty while you recovered from your wounds, in order to rob you of your memory with a fell curse and sell you to Batal as a slave. Following that, she prepared a replacement to serve as the sovereign in your stead, a mere puppet. However, with your majesty returned, I have no intention of twiddling my thumbs at Disa plays her games. I shall devise some plans to further our cause. Pray, visit me a night in the tavern that we might discuss them. This one's cleared of all suspicion, and has my permission to remain in the capital. You are to trouble the good sir no further. Are we clear?
Pray forgive me, I'm in a bit of a hurry.
Consarn it! Get back here! You there! Did you see an urchin in a cap run past just now? Can you tell me which way he went? Many thanks. I'll catch that wretch yet.
You're a kind one, aren't you? 'Twould seem I am in your debt. In fact, there's aught I would ask of you if you've the time to spare.
Aha! There you are!
Oh, apologies, but our chat will have to wait. Till next we meet. Farewell.
Looking for a craftsman?
I enjoy tackling fierce foes, and prefer combat's thrills to gathering items. Please dispense with the formalities.
Master, I've naught more to say. Pressing me further shan't change that.
I've a modest talent for spotting materials that can be used to enhance your equipment. I can even... Are you fit to travel? Then let's not dawdle.
If I learn anything of import, you will be the first to know. Where ought we to go now? There is a rumor whispered among pawns that I have oft pondered. The gist of it is, when pawns travel beyond the rift, we can contract a peculiar illness that imperils the lives of those around us. At first, we are only restless and excitable, but in time we become so unruly that even the Arisen holds no sway over us.
That sounds most unpleasant. I do hope we shall remain free of it.
This might be worth a read.
A thorough peruse.
Good day to you.
You've made yourself an enemy.
They say the Sovereign's up in the palace, recovering from his bat. Seems driving away the dragon took quite a toll on our liege. It is a right miracle he yet lives, if you ask me.
I've just recalled the little tidbit I heard from the locals.
Welcome to the Star Drop Inn. We serve all manner of fine ales here. Shall I pour you a cup to start you off? Always a pleasure.
Greetings. Welcome to the Guild Hall. Here, we conduct all manner of procedures pertaining to vocations. If there is aught I may assist you with, simply say the word. Forgive me, but I'm afraid we are not accepting registration for warriors or sorcerers at this time. You see, as we currently have no archer staves or greatswords on hand, we are unable to outfit new members. And we cannot simply purchase more, as the delivery of arms intended for the local armory and other guilds in this domain was plundered by goblins. So regrettably, I cannot assist you. Unless you were to procure a weapon yourself, that is. Let me see. What else can I tell you of our guild? Have you found any of the items we discussed, perchance? Methinks Roderick will be able to tell you aught of the stolen shipment. He runs the local armory, and we purchase almost all of our stock from him. May fortune smile upon you, sir.
First, we must find out how to procure what we require. Then our search can begin in earnest.
quartermount you seems familiar. Good evening, sir. I trust you fared all right on the roads, despite the hour.